now we're in the Regulus sector, and here's something interesting. I wasn't going to film here, because I'm skipping around between the different parts, between Klingon, Cardassian, Romulan, and Borg. But what's neat, though, is the black hole in Regulus looks like, kind of like a black hole. It's pretty neat. It's better than having a little space lane that spirals down in there, so it's pretty cool. A little interesting thing I found while checking out this mod. Essentially, while, yes, it disables the grid lines, it apparently does not yet disable these lines. If you notice, they're little circles that surround Earth. They're not too bad. I guess it's the only real place I've seen them, that and around Earth, and so it's just a small portion of the map. If you can live with that, this mod is still really good. We are now traveling in the Alpha Centauri sector block. And, so a few little interesting things here. Apparently the border is a little bit different colored. Of course you still see those lines from the circle. Once again, they're not too bad. The border lines are gone, but it appears that right at the border, there is, you know, a little shade of green and a shade of purple where the Federation and the Romulan Empire intersect. And of course it looks like it... I can't tell if it ends or not. Yeah, it doesn't look like it ends. It continues on. You know, I am now in the Alpha Centauri block, and the biggest thing I see right now, as I said, this mod's not perfect, and the biggest thing I see right now is the green area where it used to be that ugly pattern they had for the Empire. Obviously, though, they also have this little purple slice area for the neutral zone, I guess. And then getting into Federation space, it turns back to black. Now, as I said, though, this mod is not perfect yet, and it's not finished. In fact, it hasn't even been released yet. We're testing it out at Red Shirt Army. So hopefully, and I guarantee you, you'll probably get this done, it'll probably be fixed where it won't have it on, that ugly pattern there. I mean, it does have the pattern, but it won't have the ugly color. But who knows? You know what? That's the problem with modding, is, you know, it's sometimes hit and miss, and you just have to continue on to trekking at it. No pun intended. I'm sitting out by Romulus right now, and it's kind of the same story as the last sector. It's got the little green look to it. When you fly into the Federation side, it also has the blue look. But once again, though, no popsicles. The little circle line. But there's no grid lines, no popsicles, and it still looks a lot bigger and a lot better. Now for the special treat, the Gamma Uranus sector. You know, the place where they had that ugly green pattern. Now, I'm happy about this place, because it doesn't have green underneath it, so obviously he can remove it, it just takes time. But the best part is, it doesn't have that ugly green Borg pattern they have. It looks clean. The planets look green for some reason, but I think that's from the reflection of this over here. Could be wrong. But overall, though, it looks a lot better. Looks bigger. Yeah. So, this has pretty much been the tour. I've covered every single spot on the map. I didn't go over everywhere, though. Went to the Klingons, Cardassians, the new sectors, Romulans, and now Borg. And as I have to say, I really do love this mod. In fact, I'll probably be keeping it on my computer. I mean, it doesn't affect the gameplay at all. It just makes it look 1,000 times better. And quite frankly, it's as soon as it gets released, it's something you should definitely check out. But it isn't without its problems. As you know, they obviously still have those little circle lines. There's also the green and blue coloring in the Romulan sector. And there's one last problem on Earth, Stardock. The problem I was talking about isn't here, actually. You see, this place normally has a little globe around it, and you know, people working around it. If you notice, though, it is missing. It's got these little squares floating around. Apparently what has happened, though, is in disabling the popsicle sticks and disabling the grid lines, somehow, this is disabled. And from what Pindra understands, apparently Cryptic used the same type of model or some part of the grid line is tied into this. So without the grid lines, this doesn't show up. Now, it's not a huge problem, it doesn't look too bad. I mean, I guess if you want the little earth spinning there, that's fine. But if you really want the grid lines gone and the black space gone, definitely, you know, download this mod. It's worth, you know, taking a little hit here, and who knows. Great thing about mods is we might figure out what the problem is and fix it. So, this has been my little tour. All these mods have been produced by Pendra, and once again though, they are client-side mods. They do not affect gameplay. They do not mess up. They should not mess up your game, and you will not get in trouble for them. The only reason why you would get in trouble for having a mod is if it affects the gameplay and makes you cheat, which none of these do. All they do is just change out the texture mods. So, I hope you enjoy it. What I'll do is I will link a link to Pendra's website, and of course I'll have a link on redshirtarmy.com. And this has been Zodi's report from Deck 15. Although technically though, instead of being on Deck 15, I was out on assignment today. Thank you for watching. Oh, I forgot one important thing. The Elkars mod and the Barn Door mod are on his website. His website is stow-advance.com. You could also pick up a mouse mod and a first-person shooter mod and a smaller version of the Galaxy mod, where essentially it's just a popsicle sticks removed. The grid lines are still there, but it still looks a lot better without them. And you can rock that until he releases his newest version, which is currently in testing. And it's what I showed you today. So, it looks like Janeway wants me to go back down to Deck 15, where I get to sit at my little window and think about the Big Bang and warp theories and stuff like that, where I'm all alone, and it's sad and cold. So, I'll talk to you guys later. It's been fun, and back to my little hole.